Hi, good morning everyone. Today we are going to discuss application of operational amplifier. So in this video we are going to see these contents. First we are going to see the introduction about operational amplifiers. Second we are going to talk about the inverting amplifier, and third we are going to discuss with the non-inverting amplifier. Then we are going to finish with the summary. First the introduction part. Operational amplifier, or shortly called as op-amp. It is an IC with an 8 pin one, so it has two inputs and one output. So second pin and third pin is going to act as an input. Second pin is an inverting terminal and third pin is going to be a non-inverting terminal, and sixth pin is going to act as an output. Here we have two supply pins, seventh pin and fourth pin is going to act as a supply pin. Seventh pin is going to be a plus VCC and fourth pin is going to be a minus VCC. So normally we are going to apply either plus 12 volt, minus 12 volt, or plus 15 volt, minus 15 volt for this IC. Why this IC is called as operational amplifier? So here we are going to see what are the different operations that can be performed by the operational amplifier. So operational amplifier normally do all the basic operations like summing, subtractions, comparisons, differentiation and integrations. So hence it is called as an operations. So here it is called as operational, and amplification means it can either boost up the signal or it can pull down the signals. If I apply 2 volt means it can increase or strengthen the signal to 4 volt, or it can decrease the signal to 1 volt. So hence it is called as an amplifier. So it performs certain operations as well as it do some scaling operations. Hence it is called as operational amplifier. So next we are going to move to inverting amplifier. What is called as inverting amplifier? So already I have mentioned, so operational amplifier has two input terminals. One is going to be inverting, another is going to be non-inverting terminal. If you apply input voltage to the inverting terminal, that is the second pin of the operational amplifier, then it is said to be inverting amplifier. So here this is the simple circuit diagram for your inverting amplifier. So here you have two resistors, that is input resistor and feedback resistor. So the output voltage is fed back to the input terminal by means of this feedback resistor. Here the main objective of this inverting amplifier is, if you apply a DC voltage, it is going to do a negative, that is a scaling factor. That is, if you apply 2 volt means, if the gain factor is 1 mod means, it is going to give the output voltage of minus 2 volt. That is, the negative value is going to be occur here. If you give minus 2 volt means, it is going to produce 2 volt. Similarly, if I give the AC signal means, if you give a sinusoidal signal, the output is going to be just the inverse of this one, that is a cosine signal. Here it is going to produce a phase shift. So AC signal, it produces phase shift. For the DC signal, it is going to give the polarity values. So now let us give how we can design the value of resistor or gain for this inverting amplifier. Here we have the node terminals. So I am redrawing the circuit here. So let us call this node as VA. By applying nodal voltage at this point, we are going to get the derivations. That is, this current entering this node, considering this current entering this node, we are going to write the nodal equation. So considering this point, so for this nodal one, we have VA minus V in divided by RIN. And for this one, we are going to have VA minus V naught divided by RF. So that is equal to 0. So for gain, the formula for gain is output voltage to the input voltage. So to in order to achieve this, we have to find the value of VA. Here VA can be calculated by means of virtual ground concept. So what is the voltage across this terminal is going to be lie here. So here we are connected to that terminal to the ground. So here VA is going to be 0. Since VA is 0, substituting VA equal to 0 here, we are going to obtain minus V in divided by R in plus, sorry, minus minus V naught by RF equal to 0. So rearranging this equation, we are going to get V naught equal to by VI, in that is gain, that is equal to minus RF by RI in. So this is the equation for gain factor in terms of your inverting amplifier. If I choose RF equal to RIN, the gain value becomes 1, which means if I apply any input signal, the negative value of the input signal will be produced. So if you give 2 volt, minus 2 volt, minus 2 volt means it is going to be 2 volt. Similarly, if I increase the value of RI equal to 2 times RIN, I am going to get the gain factor of 2 voltage. So which means if I apply 2 volt, it is going to give the minus 4 volt as the output. So this is going to be your inverting amplifier. Now let us move on to the next one, that is going to be non-inverting amplifier. So in here, non-inverting amplifier means we are going to apply the input voltage at the non-inverting terminal, that is the third pin of your operational amplifier. Here the remaining supply is going to remain the same, the only the input voltage is going to change from inverting terminal to the non-inverting terminal. Here we are applying the input voltage at the terminal 3. Now again, to obtain the value of gain formula, we have to calculate the value of ratio between V naught to V in. So for this, now consider this circuit. Here again from the virtual concept, what is the voltage present at this terminal is equal to voltage at this terminal. So V in is present here, so similarly the V in is going to be here. So I am redrawing the circuit, so let us start with the V out. So V out R2 R1 and ground, and the voltage at this point is going to be V in. So by using the potential divider rule, if you write the equation for V in, so V in is going to be V out divided by R1 plus R2. So this is going to give the current value of the given circuit, and I am going to take the output here, so which means I have to include the value of the resistor. So this is going to be R1, so into R1. So rearranging these equations, and I have to get the gain value, so V out by V in, so which means V out by V in is going to be R1 plus R2 divided by R1. So that is 1 plus R2 by R1. If I keep R2 equal to R1, the gain here is going to be 2. So if I apply input voltage 2 means it is going to produce the output of voltage 4. So by adjusting the value of R2 and R1, we can set the gain value up to our desired value. Similarly, if you apply the AC voltage, means here only the signal magnitude will be amplified, not the inversion will take place. So this is going to be the operation of your non-inverting amplifier. Let us have a summary. For designing inverting and non-inverting amplifier, we require only a 2 resistors value. So by proper selecting of the resistor value, we can adjust the gain value of inverting as well as non-inverting amplifier. If we consider inverting amplifier alone, DC voltage, the polarity is going to change. For AC voltage like sinusoidal or cosine, the signal is going to be inverted. So that is the changes happening in the inverting amplifier. If we consider the non-inverting amplifier, means the signal is going to amplify for both AC as well as DC. So we have discussed inverting and non-inverting amplifier in this video. So let us continue this one in the upcoming videos. Thank you.